Hey, good morning, viewers. You can see by this sign where we are. This is Baker, California, along the Highway 15. And we came in the backside through Pahrump, Nevada to cash some lottery tickets here at the Lucky Lottery store. And we're just giving you a little bit of a view on the way. This is also the location of the tallest thermometer. And we are going to show you that in about a quarter of a mile here. I think the reason, I'm looking at it off to my left here, but I'll show it to you a little better. 66 degrees this morning. It's about 7:30 on a May morning. I think the reason they put that thermometer here is the fact that it gets to be 115, 16. I think I've seen it 117 or 18 degrees here in previous trips. But anyways, this is what they consider the four-way here as far as the stop. Wait for everybody to get out of the way here. This is one of the little country stores. Anyways, I'm going to show you. There used to be a Bob's Big Boy here, which unfortunately is deserted. We used to stop in there. Anyways, I hope you can see this. This thermometer is dubbed as the largest thermometer, and it's only on 66 degrees right now. Anyways, this was the Bob's Big Boy, which is probably the last of an era here. We are going to go up to the Lucky Lottery store, as they call it here. One of the few things that Baker kind of offers. This is where we get our lottery tickets a lot, and we're going to do one abandoned video here. There is a, from what I remember, the Hawaiian Motel, and it's long since closed up. But we're going to show you that here. So stand by. Actually, I think I just passed it and it was demolished. But if we don't have an abandoned video on the Hawaiian Motel, let's go back and we'll take a peek at it. People have asked us for a driving video through some of these small towns, which we like. We like the idea. I'm waiting to turn around here. Just had a little traffic jam here in Baker. There was three cars coming, so. Yeah, up here on the right, I just saw a pile of rubble, and I think that was the Hawaiian Motel. And I'm going to tell you who did a video on that one in a minute here. Well, let me see. This is not it. This place here is still open. The Santa Fe Motel. And of course, Highway 15 is known for the Mad Greek Cafe. There's a couple of these. I do believe they've put one up in Vegas. Kind of a funny family that owns that place. I've actually played poker with him in Vegas before. See, the Bun Boy is closed. He's got a Mad Greek sign coming up. Advertises Euros. I think we're coming up on... This place is supposed to have great Mexican food. I've heard that from more than one person, so I recommend it. Yeah, coming up on the Royal Hawaiian Motel. We're going to get out and do a little walkthrough there for you and see what's left. We know this video has been done before, but we have never done it. Maybe we'll get a little different insight here. But as you can see, the Royal Hawaiian is all but gone. Maybe we can drive through part of this back lot first. Let's drive around this and then we'll get out here in a minute. Unfortunately, as you see, all these palm trees are dead, so this thing has been empty for quite some time. Air conditioners are all gone. Yeah, this is definitely a derelict property. Everything on the bottom floor is boarded up for obvious reasons, but we're gonna get out here. Stand by and we'll take a look, see around, and see if there's anything of interest. While we're here, we don't get to Baker every day, so this looks like it was the pool area. Sorry about the juggling here. Yeah, this was definitely the this definitely still is the pool, but other than maybe having no, there's no water in there either. It does get pretty warm out here. Kind of an interesting piece of equipment here. That's what they call a whacker for doing compacting. This looks like it was kind of a swanky place, you know, for a roadside attraction in its day. This may have been the reason may have been for the collapse, having to do with our 07 recession. We'll see if we can't look in a room here and make sure we don't spot any squatters. See a little bit of artwork there. Professional file assistant. And as you can see, the copper thieves have been here, so when that happens, it seems like these buildings have to be just demolished at that point. Looks like they've done quite a bit of scrapping here. It's a shame to see these palm trees, though. Once they just out here in the desert, they don't get water, they don't live. Looks like there might have been 30 or 35 rooms here, something like that. Had a nice pool. Unfortunately, now it's looks like the trash heap. A little more interesting graffiti there. At least it's not hateful graffiti. Must be a stairway somewhere to get to the front side of these upper deck rooms. That's some leftover televisions out here. Looks like they've broken them all. Let's see if we can't go around the front and give you a little better view. They're fencing keep this property secure. Wasn't the most substantial. Off to the side here, looks like it was maybe see some construction equipment, trucks, etc. And I see the doors up top have been secured, and we are going to respect the no trespassing sign and not infringe too much on the property. Well, here's a bunch of palm trees. Like somebody may have attempted to either clean this up, secure it, or something, but didn't do that great of a job. Never know, and there could be people living in these rooms, but I imagine as they're open to the weather, there's probably not a lot left of them. However, that plywood, OSB, is fairly new, because I see the stickers, the SKU tags from a Home Depot or something, so... Anyways, we're going to go back around to the front, hopefully where the office is, might be able to see something in there. But this is the Royal Hawaiian Arnie's. Let me see if I can get a close-up of that sign there. It says Arnie's Royal Hawaiian Motel. I think this has more rooms than I originally thought, too. I think it may have more like 60 or 70. Here's a room that's open. We'll take a look-see. We'll see if this front building was either a kind of a coffee shop or... Yeah, not much left of these rooms. This place is full of hay. This is full of hay. Like somebody had, I don't know if the hay blew in there or somebody had an animal. Boy, that's weird. Where would all that hay come from? I'm going to walk around the front of this and see if this was actually, I would imagine this was probably some kind of a cafe or something. I think the office is behind us. Another closed down business across the street with that sunroom. It looks suspiciously like a Wendy's, but it's just not quite the right roof line for a Wendy's. Well, here's a little better view of the sign. Arnie's Arnie's Motel. I imagine within the next few years, with the economy getting better, this place will probably be leveled. With technology today and building codes, etc. Now here's a little bit of life to some of these palm trees. The little short ones have survived. But with technology today, they would never be able to rebuild this. It's just too far gone. Yeah, I imagine that was either the office or the... I don't see any vents on the roof for restaurant-type equipment. I see the roof is just about half blown off there, but... Anyways, we thought we would give you a short tour of what's left of the Royal Hawaiian. Here's one palm tree with a little bit of life left. Probably not too long, though. I feel like dumping a bucket of 5-gallon bucket of water at the base, but that would probably just be a band-aid on the situation. So anyways, look back in this room here. Yeah, there's a that's interesting right there. That is definitely Royal Hawaiian style furniture. I'm glad we saw that here at the end. Anyways, guys, that's what's left of the Royal Hawaiian in Baker, California. It's a shame. It's gone. Gone forever. These roadside stops, not really an attraction, but definitely a place where people have been. Gone forever. Appreciate you being here, guys. If you haven't subscribed, this would be a great time. We appreciate it. Nevada Arcade, out.